back in the day. Them cats coming out of Pittsburgh, Vibria, Kansas City. Way back when. When it laid on up to Winton. Marcellus and that crowd. You see, it was like this. There I was, in the basement of this office building, down there around Brooklyn Bridge. Rehearsal studios. And like, there was Bird. Bird with his arm around Whitney Marcella's shoulder. Bent me all out of shape. I couldn't figure out what the hell was Bird doing with his arms around Whitney Marcella's shoulder. But then it seemed to change. All these musicians, all these fantastic jazz musicians, hustling and running across Brooklyn Bridge, descending into the city, the Big Apple, down there around City Hall, bright and early one morning, just running. And there was this one guy who looked just like Lester Young. Then his image kept changing. Then he started looking like Billy Eckstein. Then back to Lester. Then Billy. Then Lester. Then Billy. And I ran up to him and I said, "Say, man, who's got the key?" He looked at me and says, "Key? What key?" He said, "Gus got the key." I said, Gus who?" He said, "Don't you know? Gus Johnson got the key." And that's when I did my research. Searched around the jazz scene, did a history of the music, inside out, outside in. Talked to one old timer way back when, who said, "Yeah, don't you know Gus Johnson was a drummer back out of Kansas City?"